Today, I start new chapter. The chapter is operators and expressions. In Java, operator and expression. At first, we have to know what is operators. Operator is a symbol to perform arithmetic and logical operation. Operator is a symbol to perform arithmetic or logical operation. You can also say it is a token. Let A plus B multiplied with C. What is operator? These are operator. It is called an expression. A, B, C. These are operand. Basically, there are three types of operators. First one is arithmetical. Next is relational. And last one is logical. So three types of operator: arithmetical, relational and logical. Now, arithmetical operator. What is arithmetical operator? The operator which are applied to perform arithmetical calculation in a program are known as arithmetical operator. Some basic calculation like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, modulus, these are arithmetical operators like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, modulus. Now, what is the difference between arithmetical expression and arithmetical statement. In arithmetical expression, may contain variable, constant and arithmetical operator together to produce a meaningful result. Suppose x plus y in minus 15 b multiplied with b minus 4 multiplied with a into c. If an arithmetical expression is assigned to a variable, then it is known as an arithmetical statement. Variable equals to this is arithmetical expression, this is arithmetical statement. Now we will learn how mathematical expressions are written in Java expression. Here we write mathematical expression. Java mathematical expression, Java expression. A B C. How can I write in Java? A B C. Clear? A B plus BC plus CD. Clear? Now A square plus B square. We will write A into A plus B into B. Into L plus B into L plus B. ERT by 100 into R into T by there are three types of arithmetical operators. Unary operator, binary operator and ternary operator. At first go to unary operator. What is unary operator? An arithmetical operator which is applied with single operand. Applied with single operand is known as unary operator. There are two types of unary operator. First one is unary plus operator. And second one is unary minus operator. What is unary plus operator? This operator is applied before the operand. Before the operand. Clear? If a equals to 8. If a equals to 8, then plus a will result 8. If a equals to minus 10, then plus a will result minus 10. It is unary operator. It is unary plus operator. In case of unary minus operator, this operator is used in the same way as unary plus operator. It is also applied before the operand. Unary minus reverts the sign of a operand. Remember this point. Unary minus reverts the sign of the operand. That is, if a equals to 4, then minus a will result minus 4. Clear? Only revert the sign. If a equals to 0, then minus a will result zero. If equals to minus 3.6, then minus a will result 3.6. Revert the sign. Now unary increment and decrement operator. Unary increment and decrement. Unary increment and decrement operator. Unary increment operator is written as plus plus, and decrement operator is written as minus minus. Unary increment operator plus plus increase the value of the operand by 1. Unary decrement operator minus minus decrease the value of an operand by 1. It is increase the value, it is decrease the value. Let x is equal to x plus 1. By applying increment operator, it can be written as x plus plus. Okay. Or plus plus x. One example, p is equal to p minus 1. By applying decrement operator, you can write p minus minus or minus minus p. Here increment operator is written just after the operand, and here increment operator is written before the operand. So what is the difference between this after and before? Unary increment decrement operator, two types. One is prefix and another is postfix. When the increment or decrement operator are applied before the operand, it is known as prefix operand. When increment or decrement operators are applied before the operand, it is known as prefix operators. This operator works on the principle change before action. Change before action. Change before action. It means the value of the variable changes before the operation takes place. Example of prefix: p is equal to 5, p is equal to plus plus p 4. Here p is initialized as the value 5, and equation is p is equal to plus plus p multiplied with 4. So here it is prefix operation. Prefix mean change before the action. Action is multiplication, so this value will be changed before multiplication. So the value will be change means what value? It will be increment by 1, so it will be 6. Then it is multiplied with 4 and answer will 24. Example of prefix decrement. Suppose d is equal to 11, t equal to 4 plus minus minus d. You will get 4 plus, it is also prefix. Prefix means change before the action. Action is addition, so changes will be minus minus d. This value will be decrement by 1, so it will be 10. After this addition will perform 14. Clear? I am giving example of postfix operation. P equal to 5, P equals to P plus plus into 4. This is postfix, means change after the action. Action means the multiplication, means P will be changed after this action. So it will remain same, 5 into 4, 20. If I write p equals to 5, p is equal to p plus plus 4 plus p. So it will be 5 into 4. This p will be changed after the multiplication, so it is increment by 1 and goes to p, it will be 6, so you will get 26. is equal to 5, p equal to p minus minus into 4. So remain same, 5 into 4 you will get 20, p equals to 5, p equal to p minus minus into 4 plus p. So it will be 5. After the action it decrement by 1 value, so it will be 4, so the answer will be 24. Clear? All these postfix and prefix, increment and decrement operations. Now I am writing some shorthand operations. Here expression a shortened form. A equals to a plus b. You can write as a shortened a plus equal to b. C equals to C minus D. C minus equals to D. M equals to M multiply to 10. You can write equals to 10. D equals to D by 2. You can write y equals to 2. X is equal to x mod 2. You can write x mod equals to 2. This is the shorthand form of these respective expressions. Y is equal to 14. Then find z equal to plus plus y, multiply to it y plus 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 5. Z is equal to, this is the problem. Z equal to x plus y plus x plus 5. Here y is 14. Prefix. So it is prefix. So increment is done before the operation. So it will be 15. Then y plus plus. Y plus plus means what is the value of y? Y is 15. The increment will be after the addition. So it will be 15 plus 5, and that will be 15 multiplied to it 20, and we will get 300. Another example, if a is equal to 4, b is equal to 3, then find C is equal to A plus plus multiplied with 6 plus 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 B multiplied with 5
n plus 10. C is equal to a plus plus multiplied with 6 plus 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 b multiplied with 5 plus 10. A plus plus. A plus plus means the value will be remain same. 6 plus 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 b. Plus plus b means b is 3. So it will be increment by 1. The value will be 4 into 5 plus 10. It will be 24 plus 20 plus 10. And you will get 54. Now, what is binary arithmetic operator? Binary arithmetic operator which deal with two operand. That is addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, modulus. These operations. What is relational operator? These operators are used to show the relationship among the operand. Relational operator compare the value of the variables and the result in terms of true and false. Write the symbols. Format. Symbol is less than. What is the format? Suppose two variables are a and b, so a less than b, greater than a, greater than b. Okay, relational. This less than or equal to a, less than equal to b, greater than equal to a, greater than equal to b. Equal to a equal to b, not equal to a not equal to b. Next is logical operators. Java uses logical operator and, or, not. Symbols are and is written as this, or is, and not is this. And what is the format of writing and? Suppose two variables a and b. A and b. A and b. Or a or b, not a not b. And the and operator result in true if both expressions are true. If 5 greater than 3 and 3 less than 5, result is true. Because both the expression are true. 6 equals 2 equals to 5 and 3 greater than 0. Here result is false because 6 is not equals to 5, but this condition is true. In case of AND operation, AND two both condition will be true, so you will get false. This operator is used to combine two conditional expression. It will result in true if either of two condition is true, otherwise false. Let 5 greater than 4 or 8 greater than 12. Result is true. One condition is true, then result will be true in case of OR. 3 greater than 7 or 5 less than equal to 4. What will be the result? 3 greater than 7, it is false. 5 less than equal to 4, it is also false. So result will be false. One condition must be satisfied. Satisfied means one condition must be true and we will get true. If two condition is false, you will get false. One more example. 2, 12. Two less than 0 and 12 greater than 2, it is true and you will get 2. Next is NOT. Logical NOT operator is applied when you want to revert the outcomes of an expression. It is a unary operator because it uses a single operand. NOT 8 greater than 3, it will be result false because 8 greater than 2, 3 is 2. 8 greater than is 2. NOT means just revert the result. So this true is reverted to false. NOT 5 less than 7, it is also true and there is a NOT means the result will be reverted. So result will be false. NOT 3 less than 0, it is condition is false, it is reverted by NOT, so you will get true. Ternary operators, or it is called conditional assignment. Ternary operator deals with three operands. It is also called conditional assignment because the value assigned to a variable depends upon a logical expression. The syntax is variable equal to text test expression expression 1 is to expression 2. The variables contains the result of expression 1 if test condition is true, otherwise expression 2. Look at an example. A equals to 5, B equals to 3. Max is equal to A greater than B. A is to B. Here the value 5 is stored in max as A greater than B is true. Mean B greater than A, A is to B. The value 3 is stored in mean as B greater than A is false. The syntax is variable equals to test expression, expression 1, expression 2. The variable contains the result of expression 1 if test condition is true. Here A greater than B means A greater than B. Condition is test expression is A greater than B. And write here the values 5 is to 3. So A greater than B, 5, what is the value of B? 3. So 5 greater than 3, condition is true, test expression is A greater than B. Condition is satisfied, you will get the expression 1. If it is false, so you get the result 3. So 5 is stored in max. Here also B greater than A, here 5 is to 3, B greater than A, condition test expression is B greater than A, condition is false. So if it is false, what will be the result? Result in the expression 2, it is 3. So mean equal to 3. Nested conditional operator. Nested you can use conditional operator, ternary operator in nested form as below. Int A equals to 5, B equals to 12, C equals to 3, max is equal to A greater than B, test expression A greater than C is to C is to this is test expression expression 1 expression 2.
The test condition is A greater than B. It is false because A is 5, B is 12. The test expression is false because the value A is 5 and B is 12. So it will operate on the expression 2. In expression 2, the test expression is B greater than C. What is the value of B? B is 12 and C is 3. Condition is true. So if condition is true, you will get the value of B. B is 12. So max is equal to 12.